Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I thank God for this day. God has given a privilege to come on live in this group. Hallelujah. God bless each and everybody, those who are watching. Hallelujah. Today is the 70th day, Independence Day, which Israel has got independence. So this is 70th year of independence. So all the Israelites are celebrating today. So before coming into the word, into the message, let us pray for Israel. In the Bible, when we read Bible, we can see that the number 70 has much importance. Moses selected 70 elders. And Jesus also selected the 12 disciples from the 70. He chose the 12 apostles from the 70 disciples. So 70 has much importance in Bible. So this is today is the 70th year of Independence Day of Israel. In 1948, May 14, today, 70 years back, Israel got independence. So they are celebrating. So let us celebrate with all the Israelites, because the Israelites are the chosen people of God. They are the descendants of Abraham. The Bible says that every person who has been, who has received Holy Spirit and who has been accepted Jesus as the Savior is the son of Abraham. So we also have the right to celebrate the independence of Israel. So I have the shofar with me. So let me blow the shofar and let us pray before coming into the message. Let us pray for Israel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, my Father, let us close eyes. Lord, my Father, I thank you, Father, for giving me an opportunity to come on live. Today is the 70th day of independence. So all the Israelites and we all who have accepted Jesus as Savior, we are celebrating the independence, the victory of Israelites. We know that the number 70 has much importance in the Bible. So today, this day is an anointed day. It is a blessed day. Let each and everybody, those who are watching this message today, let them be blessed. Now on live also and later, those who are watching, let them be blessed. Let Holy Spirit speak. I submit myself to you, Lord. Let Holy Spirit take over the circumstance control. Let there be all the light, everything. Let there be picture clarity, everything. Let there be network, everything, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. So today also God will speak. Today I am sharing with you about prophet is a bubbling man. Prophet is a bubbling man. Hallelujah. In the last episode also I was saying that a prophet carry the burden of God. When we look the Bible, when we read the book of Isaiah and all the Jeremiah, we can see those prophets have carry the burden of God. Their hearts are very, they are crying prophets. They cry for the nations. They cry for the people. When God has a feeling of hatred, these prophets also have the feeling of hatred. When God has a loving kindness to the people, these prophets also have a loving kindness, because they have the heart of God. So today I am telling you is about a prophet is a bubbling man. What is a bubbling man? Because the word doesn't come from himself. When the Holy Spirit comes upon a person, when the prophetic anointing comes upon a person, automatically he speaks on behalf of God. He will be given a new heart. He will be given a new mouth. And God takes control over the mouth of a prophet. We can see that. I am going to read one verse. In 2 Peter chapter 1, 21 verse, it says that, hallelujah. Before reading the word, Holy Spirit is giving you a word. Hallelujah. Sister, I see your name, sister. Holy Spirit wants to talk to you. Holy Spirit is giving a deliverance in your family. Sister Sandra Joseph, I see you have some connection in Middle East. You have some connection in Middle East, I see. God is molding your family. Some financial deliverance I see in your family. Hallelujah. Whatever you are worrying at this moment, God is saying that everything is now going for the blessing. A blessing is coming later. So God is saying to relax. Something is making you worried, but if a deliverance I see in your family, also I see a financial deliverance. Hallelujah. New connections coming to you. Hallelujah. Rely to God. God, Holy Spirit is saying, rely everything to God. God can turn everything upside down. God can change the situations. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So I am reading the verse, 2 Peter, 1st chapter, 21, the verse. It says, for prophecy never come by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. So the verse is saying that prophecy never come by the will of man. It is not saying a prophecy is not said after studying, taking much time for studies. When a teacher takes a Bible class, he will give the class eloquently after taking a thorough study in the Bible. But in the case of a prophet, prophecy is not coming after taking a detailed study, after a long study. Now I am here, coming on live. I have read the verses, but if any prophecy, any revelation comes, it is not coming by after a long study in the late night. No, it will come at the moment when Holy Spirit comes and when we are moved. That's what the verse is saying, that prophecy never come by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. When Holy Spirit comes, we will be moved. How we will know the movement of Holy Spirit? When Holy Spirit tells you to pray, you must pray. When Holy Spirit tells you to read Bible, you must read Bible. When Holy Spirit tells you to go to a house and pray, you must go to that house and pray. Don't make it delay. What Holy Spirit says, you must say that at once. That you must understand the movement of Holy Spirit. And you must respond to the movement of Holy Spirit. Then only you can prophesy. So Peter is saying that all the prophecies in the Bible are written and said by when Holy Spirit come and when they are moved by the Holy Spirit. So when we read the book of Hosea, we can see that God told Hosea to marry a prostitute in order to show the Israelites that the future of Israelites will be like this. So God told Hosea to marry a prostitute in order to show the Israelites that the future of Israelites will be like this. Likewise, Isa, the prophet, was told by God to walk barefoot without chapels for 3 years. Hallelujah. And God told to remove his clothes, and he walked without clothes. We can see that in the book of Isa, chapter 23rd verse. Then the Lord said to Isa, just as my servant Isa has walked naked and barefoot 3 years for a sign, 3 years for a sign and wonder against Egypt and Assyria, so will happen to this Egypt and Ethiopia. So God wants to give a revelation. God wants to prophesy to Ethiopia and Egypt. And it will be like that, as if a man walks barefoot. As if a man walks without clothes. So God told Isa, you walk barefoot. You walk naked. That's what the verse is saying. Isa 23 says that, just as my servant Isa has walked naked and barefoot. 3 years. 3 years Isa walked without any chappels. He walked barefoot. And he didn't wear his outer garments. Hallelujah. So sometimes God will make us also to be according to the circumstances, according to the surroundings. Jeremiah was a man of, he's always called as a weeping prophet. So whenever he prophesied, he cried. When he looked into the heart of people, he was moved by the people. He was moved by the circumstances and he cried. So we prophets are like that. We must be moved by the surroundings. Sometimes God will give messages through the surroundings. Hallelujah. Sometimes God will give through the surroundings, through the circumstances. Suppose if a person asks you for a message, you are not getting any vision. You are not getting any revelation. But one day when I was praying for when I went into a house, and that person in that house asked me for a revelation. God didn't give me any revelation. God didn't spoke to me. I didn't hear any audible voice. But that person said, "You please give me a word." And I asked God, "God, you are not giving me a revelation. You are not speaking to me. Then how will I give him a revelation? You are not giving me a word in the Bible. Then how will I give revelation?" God told. God told to me at the door and said, "You look at the door." And I looked at the door of the house. And God told me, "What you are seeing?" I have seen the door closed. Then tell that person that your future seems like everything closed. So it is a method of prophesying. So I told that person, "Everything is closed." Then that person said, "Yeah, you are said correct." So it is a method. We have to move according to the circumstances. If Holy Spirit only tells, if only God says, if only God says, only you can move according to the circumstances. So God told Isa, "You take off your outer clothes and you take off your chappels. You walk barefoot." And he walked for 3 years. God told Hosea, "You marry a prostitute," and Hosea married a prostitute in order to give a message to the Israelites. Likewise, when we read the book of Acts, we can see that there was a prophet Agabus, and Agabus came near to Paul, and he took the belt of Paul, and he said, "The man who owns his belt," and he bound the belt around Paul and said, "The man who owns his belt will be bound like this before the Gentiles." So he showed like that. He could say, but he also showed. He also acted. Sometimes we prophets have to act like that. Also, when we read the Old Testament, we can see that there was a prophet Ahijah. He wanted to prophesy. He wanted to prophesy to the people that he wanted to tell the Israelites that the Israel kingdom will be teared like a cloth that will be teared into 12 pieces. So Ahijah the prophet took a piece of cloth and he tore it into 12 pieces and said, "The kingdom of Israel will be divided like this, which I have torn this cloth into 12 pieces. It will be divided into 12 tribes," as the King Solomon was departing from the word of God. So sometimes the prophets are like that. We have to act. We have to get a word from the surroundings, circumstances, if God only says. Hallelujah. So I am telling you that, I am reading that 1 Samuel chapter 10, 6th verse. I am reading. "Then the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you." Samuel the prophet is telling Saul. Saul was anointed as the king of Israel, and before sending him away, Saul was saying this to Saul. That's what I am reading. "Then the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you, and he will prophesy and be turned into another man." So Saul is telling Samuel is telling Saul that when you go, the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you, and you will be moved into, you will become another man. So when you prophesy, I am telling you, you will become another man.
You will become an another man. God will give you a new heart. I will read another verse in the 10th verse, 1 Samuel 10th verse. So it was when he had turned his back to go from Samuel, then that God gave him another heart. So from these two verses we can say then you will become another man and you will be giving a new heart. Maybe at the moment you have no revelation. So I am looking at you. I am seeing a name. Hallelujah. Sister, I am looking at you and saying, God is giving me a new heart. God is giving me God has changed me into a new person. So I could prophesy. Financial deliverance, I see. Adore me. Financial deliverance. The process is going. Cycling is going. Just wait. Just wait for the Lord. Lord is saying it is moving. I see the cycling is moving. All the doors are closed. All the windows are closed. I see, Sister Adomi. But God has kept a little gap in that closed window. I see. So an opening is coming for you. An opening is coming for you. You look through that opening and you will see the deliverance. Hallelujah. You will get the news from abroad. You will get the news from others. Others will come to know about your deliverance. Hallelujah. So something is preparing. God is preparing something for you. Hallelujah. I hear the sound. Something is, God is making something for you. And you have to move. You have to move very, very fast. Hallelujah. You are going to reach your office. You are going to sit in your office. I see you referring many books. Hallelujah. I see you meditating the word. I see you preaching. So this will happen. This is happening. Hallelujah. You are going to reap. Hallelujah. It is the time for harvest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I am telling you that. I am coming into the, thank you Holy Spirit. So when Saul left Samuel, it really happened as like Samuel said. Samuel said that you will be turned into another person and you will be given another heart. So when we are in the prophetic realm, we will be changed into another person. We will be given a new heart. And God will be with us. God will put the words in our mouth. I am reading one verse in the book of Exodus chapter 4, 12th verse. It says, now therefore go and I will be with you, your mouth, and teach you what you say. God is saying, because Moses has a prophetic calling. He has a prophetic anointing, but he was not willing to go what God said. He was against what God said. So he said, I cannot speak. But God is saying that, I will teach you. So are you not getting any words? Ask God. God, you told Moses that you will teach. So teach us. Teach us. I am looking at the people, those who are watching. Lord, give me revelation. Teach me. Teach me the words. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Teach me, Lord. So Moses was taught by God. Also we can see then in the 15th verse, now you shall speak to him. So God is showing an example. So Moses told that I cannot speak. So God told you, call your brother also. So Aaron will speak for you. So Aaron is a prophet of you. And you are a God to Aaron. So God is showing as an example. In the verse he is saying that you shall speak to him and put the words in his mouth, and I will be with your mouth and with his mouth, and I will teach you what you shall do. And in the 16th verse we can see that, so he shall be your spokesman to the people, and he himself shall be as a mouth for you, and you shall be to him as a God. So God is saying an example. Aaron will be your spokesman. and you will be a God to him. Likewise, we are the spokesman of God. And God is going to put the words in our mouth. If only God gives a word in our mouth, then only we can speak. Hallelujah. So I am reading one verse. So he shall be your spokesman to the people, and he himself shall be as a mouth for you, and you shall be to him as God. Hallelujah. So I see, sister, finance is opening. Something you have been making, trying for a long time, but it is not in process. It is not coming into effect. Holy Spirit is saying that you will be chosen from the 12. You will be separated from the world. I see you have a deliverance ministry. Hallelujah. Your name will be known by many, and you will see the importance of the prophecies which were told to you, and you will see that it is going to happen. Hallelujah. I see you, God taking you into another direction. Hallelujah. So God is speaking to you. Hallelujah. You take that word. Hallelujah. Grace is upon you. Grace is upon you. Hallelujah. So I am reading this John 11. I see a name, Crystal Davis. Crystal Davis. Hallelujah. You pray, Holy Spirit will speak to you, beloved. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit will speak to you. Hallelujah. So I am reading that John 11, 49-52. Caiaphas prophesied, one man should die for the people, not that the whole nation should. So when we read the book of Gospels, we can see that Caiaphas is a prophet. He is not a prophet. He is a priest. He is a chief priest of the temple. But he prophesied without knowing himself that he is prophesying. Because all the people wants to crucify Jesus. They wants to put him into prison, and they want to kill him. They want to crucify him. And Caiaphas, the chief priest, is saying that, yes, it is better for one person to die for other people. Without knowing, he is prophesying. So sometimes we are like that. We do not know what we are saying. Hallelujah. We do not know. Once I went to a meeting, and I looked at a person and said, God is taking you to another country. You are going to fly to another country. And that person is about 90 years old. I looked at that person. When I said, I thought, why I am saying, Lord, he is 90 years old, and how can you travel? But after 2 months, when I went to the church, that person said, I went to USA because I had to go, because my grandson was not well and he was hospitalized. So I had to go. That person said like that. So we do not know what will it, but we are forced to say something. That's what we said. I said that a prophet is a bubbling man. A prophet is the words will come bubble forth. It will come as if somebody is pushing from our mouth. Those who speak in tongues know that. When we speak in tongues, we know that we are not speaking, somebody is speaking. Likewise, when we prophesy, we know that we are not prophesying, somebody is prophesying. So Crystal Davis, Holy Spirit is saying, fire anointing upon you. Hallelujah. Fire anointing. You are in the paddy field. You have to, I see the harvest. It is ready to reap. Go. Lord is saying, go deep, go deep. Hallelujah. Many oppositions coming, but don't be disappointed. Don't be dismayed. Hallelujah. God will lead you. God will give you the right decision. You are going to change your residence. You are looking for a house, and you are moving into another house, I see. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. So, I am telling you, when we read the book of Jeremiah, we can see that Jeremiah was afraid, because Jeremiah was called by as a prophet even before his birth. Even formed in his mother's womb, before that he was chosen as a prophet. So he had the prophetic anointing, but when God told him, Jeremiah, now this is the time for you to go and prophesy, he was dismayed. He was afraid of the people. So in the book of Jeremiah, we can see that when we read the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, 17th verse, it says, 17th verse, it says like this, book of Jeremiah, hallelujah. Thou therefore gird up the loins and arise. Lord is saying, thou therefore gird up thy loins and arise and speak unto them all that I command thee. Be not be dismayed at their faces, lest I confound thee before him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Lord is saying to Jeremiah, do not be dismayed, lest I will confound you before them. So you must understand the moment of the Holy Spirit. You must understand the time of the Holy Spirit. So if you act only, if you give the word only at that time, then only you can prophesy. Sometimes if a person comes before you for a prayer, and Holy Spirit is giving you the moment to prophesy, you must give the word at that moment. Do not be dismayed. Once I went to a church, one pastor called me to give word to a church. And when I was preaching, Holy Spirit told me that pastor and his wife are not going in the correct way. They have some problems in the money matters. They are they are corrupted. So God told me to say like that. But I didn't say. So after that, everything was going not correctly. Everything went upside down, because I was dismayed before that pastor. When Holy Spirit tells you, you say, you must say. You must have the boldness. Jeremiah was afraid before the kings, before the people. So he was dismayed. And God said in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, 17th verse, do not be dismayed, Jeremiah, lest you will be confounded before them. I will make you afraid before them. So if you have a prophetic calling, if you have a anointing, you must have the bold. That's what God will give you, a new heart. God will give you, will change you into another person. Hallelujah. So I am going to pray for you. Hallelujah. So today, those who are watching, I am telling you, your struggles, those who receive this, if you accept this, you will see the deliverance. By this time, before the sun sets, your position will be changed. Your anointing will be increased. You will see the deliverance in your family. Your son, I see your son. I am not mentioning the name, but I see your son struggling to get out from a situation. God will bring you out, bring your son out from that situation. People are calling him as a waste. Even your family calling your son as a waste. But the time is come. Yeah, I see the time has come. Changing the situation. Hallelujah. He is joining a new company. He is joining. I see. He is having a new job. Hallelujah. I see him traveling. I see God anointing him. God giving him, filling him with his Holy Spirit. God giving him new visions. I see your son reading scriptures and meditating the word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So people will be knowing your son. You will be honored. Your family will be blessed because of your son. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So I thank God. So I am going to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank each and everybody, those who are watching. Those who are watching and those who are going to be watched later, bless them. Increase their prophetic anointing. Let them see visions. Let them come to know the movement of Holy Spirit. And let them act at the right time of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let the 9 gifts of Holy Spirit be revealed in them with the fruits. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for this group, prophecy group. Thank you, Lord, for all the leaders and all the members. Bless each and everybody. Thank you, Lord, for you have given me an opportunity to come on live. Everything. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. So I'm happy. I am celebrating with those who are viewing. God bless you. Next week, same time, maybe half an hour before, I will be coming on live. Hallelujah. So we are celebrating the 70 years, the day of independence, because the Israelites are celebrating the day of independence. Bible, I told you before that, in the Bible, the number 70 has much importance. So I am once again blowing the shofar. Let the when I blow the shofar, you will have a deliverance, including me also, I believe. When the Israelites marked for the war, when they are ready for the war, God told, the Lord Jehovah told, you blow shofar, you blow trumpet. So this is a sign of deliverance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So today you will see this 70th year of Israelites as God, Israel, the country, nation Israelites has got independence in 1948. May 14th is the Independence Day of Israelites. 70 years, this is the 70th year. So we will also see today a great blessing from God. May God bless you, each and everybody. God bless you. Amen.